Hi students, coming to next topic, that is priority interrupts. So let us see what is this priority interrupts. So we already discussed what is an interrupt. Again, let's see what is an interrupt. So interrupt is nothing but it is a signal or a condition. It is a signal or a condition that causes the executing program to stop. So it is saying that signal or condition is nothing but it is saying to the processor to stop the current execution and also it says to save the state, save its states of execution and do the function call and do the function call like service the signal or condition. So this is an interrupt. So what it's saying, interrupt is nothing but a signal or a condition. You call it as a signal or a condition. From where the signal or condition will come from? Actually, the external devices or the internal software sends a signal or a condition to the processor. So it is sending the signal to the processor. So what it's saying, the processor has to stop the current execution. So whatever the execution operation it is doing, the processor, the CPU, it has to stop that current execution and it will save whatever state it is having, it is doing, and it takes the interrupt request, means it takes a signal or a condition that comes from the external devices. So this is an interrupt, means it is just disturbing the program. So see, CPU is performing some tasks. Whenever the call is occur, it will goes to that particular function. Whenever again this function is over, by seeing the return, again it backs and the CPU is proceeding to the normal work. So this complete section you call it as interrupt. Breaking the sequence of a program, breaking the execution of the system. Okay, so this is the interrupt. Actually, the data transfer between the CPU and peripherals is initiated by the CPU. So whatever the data transfer will occur from CPU to peripherals. Peripherals means the external devices. So whatever the data transfer has to be done, these will be initiated by the CPU itself. Initiated by CPU. Suppose some instruction, whatever the result, the CPU execute one operation and it comes, one result will be there. If the CPU wants to send that result to the peripherals, so first it will be initiated by CPU itself. How it initiate? Actually, CPU cannot start the transfer unless the peripherals are ready. Okay, did you understand? The CPU cannot transfer unless the peripherals are ready. So until the peripherals are ready, the CPU cannot transfer. So when it will transfer? Whenever the peripherals or sends the interrupt signal to the CPU saying that I am free, now you can send the result to my device. So whenever it sees the interrupt signal, then the CPU will send the result to the peripheral devices. So the main thing you have to be noted that the CPU cannot start the transfer unless the peripherals are ready. So whenever the peripherals are ready, then the CPU will communicate the transfer to the peripheral devices or to the external devices. So here the main job of interrupt system is to identify the source of interrupt. So why we are using the interrupt system? So here the main job of the interrupt system is to identify the source of interrupt. So what is this interrupt source? Why it is coming? So that will be placed in the interrupt system. There is a possibility that several devices will request simultaneously for CPU communication. Then interrupt system has to decide which device has to serve first. Okay, So many devices are sending, means suppose this is a CPU, so many devices are interrupting the CPU for communication. So then the CPU has to think which service has to be taken first. So that will be decided by this interrupt service routine. Okay, so this is all about the interrupt. Now let us discuss the priority interrupts. So what is this priority interrupts? Okay, so let us see what about this priority interrupts. Generally, the devices with high speed transfer, such as magnetic tape, suppose if you take magnetic disk which is having high speed of data transfer, so these having the highest priority. I'm generally saying that. So the priority interrupts, how you will differentiate the priority means, with high speed of data transfer, this magnetic disk is having the high speed of data transfer, so it is having the highest priority. And the slow devices like keyboards, suppose if you take keyboards, so these keyboards are having the lowest priority. So whenever these two are sending the same signals for communication at a time, these two are the peripherals. Okay, so these two peripherals are communicating the CPU, means by sending the signals to the CPU at the same time. So then the CPU will take first the highest priority condition. After that, it takes the lowest priority condition. Okay, so like that, the CPU will differentiate the which service has to be taken first based on the priority of interrupts, highest priority and the lowest priority. Okay, so now coming to the different types of interrupts. So we had seen interrupt, priority interrupts. Now let us see the types of interrupts. So interrupts are of two types will be there. Okay, so one is the hardware interrupt and another is the software interrupts. Okay, so one hardware interrupt and another is software interrupt. So we said that priority interrupts is based on the highest priority and the lowest priority the service will be taken by the CPU. Now coming to the types of priority, hardware interrupt, types of interrupts are of two types. One is a hardware interrupt and another is a software interrupt. So what is this hardware interrupt? This hardware interrupt is when signals come from external devices or hardware, then you call it as a hardware interrupt. So interrupt occur, the signals come from external devices or external hardware, so then you call it as a hardware interrupt. Okay, so actually suppose if you press a key in the keyboard, you call it as an external device, that will be means external peripheral device connected to the system. So whenever you press a key in the keyboard to do some action, means it is saying to the processor to do some action, then it generates interrupt signal. Okay, so example is pressing a key in keyboard. Okay, so whenever you press a key in keyboard, it sends an interrupt signal to the CPU. So now the CPU has to decide whether it has to take the keyboard request or not. So again, this hardware interrupt, this is keyboard is nothing but the hardware interrupt. So whenever this hardware interrupt is occurred, the signal sent to the CPU will decide whether it is a maskable interrupt or non-maskable. Maskable interrupt or non-maskable interrupt. Maskable hardware interrupt or non-maskable hardware interrupt. So based on this condition, the CPU will access the condition or the signal, whatever it comes from external device, it takes that interrupt request. So maskable interrupt means what? The hardware interrupt, which can be delayed when a much higher priority instruction occurred at same time. So the name itself is saying maskable. If highest priority is there, wait. Okay, highest priority is there. Whenever the maskable interrupt is occur, if the CPU is working on the highest priority instruction, it has this maskable interrupt has to be wait. So after this highest priority request is over, operation is over, it takes the maskable signal. Non-maskable means what? Okay. So non-maskable means hardware interrupt which cannot be delayed. It cannot be delayed. Okay. Non-maskable means the signal cannot be delayed and it should be processed by processor immediately. It has to be processed immediately. Okay. So this is the hardware interrupts. So these are two types will be there in the hardware interrupt, maskable and non-maskable. Maskable means you can be wait. It can be masked, the whatever the signal that is sent by the keyboard, if it is having the lowest priority, it can be wait until the highest priority interrupt is over, or it can be maskable, it can be removed. Now coming to the non-maskable, so whenever the CPU sees the signal that it is a non-maskable interrupt, the CPU cannot be delayed. It has to, whatever the operation it is doing, it has to be stopped that instruction and it takes the non-maskable request and it processes immediately. After the completion of this non-maskable instruction, it again continues with the normal work. Okay, so this is about the hardware interrupts. Now coming to the next type, that is a software interrupt. So actually this software interrupt caused by internal systems. So internal system of computer system. Okay, so whatever the internal instructions will be there, the interrupt occurred in the software, then you call it as this software interrupt. So these are again hardware is of two types. One is maskable and another is non-maskable. Software is also of two types. One is normal interrupt and another is exception. Okay, so software interrupts are of again two types. One is normal interrupt, another is exception. Normal interrupt means the interrupt caused by software instructions. So interrupt caused by software instruction. So whenever the interrupt occur in the software instructions, if you are writing the series of steps in the program, whenever the interrupt is occurred, you call it as a normal interrupt. So what about this exception? Exception is nothing but unplanned interrupt. Unplanned interrupt means before you never think that interrupt is occurred, suddenly it comes. So in the program, if the sudden interrupt is occurred, then you call it as an exceptional interrupt. Unplanned interrupt, which are produced during the execution of some program, are called exceptions, just like divide by zero. Example of this exception is divide by zero. Okay, so these are the different types of interrupts. Hardware interrupt and software interrupt. Hardware interrupt again having the maskable interrupt and non-maskable interrupt. These hardware interrupts are come from the external devices. The signal or a condition comes to the CPU from external devices. Whereas a software interrupt is nothing but it is the interrupt occurred within the system. So these are of all two types, normal interrupt and exceptional interrupt. Normal interrupt means caused by software instruction itself. Exception interrupt means unplanned interrupt. Okay, so this is all about the priority interrupts.